It's a good AGam in Kansas morning. Good morning. Let's take a look and see what's coming up today.
First, Dr. Ignacio Ciampitti discusses the upcoming crop production schools. Then Dr. Nels Lindberg with the Animal Medical Center in Great Bend and Luke Knight with the Knight Feedlot in Lyons discuss tips on to improve interactions with your employees. Next, Dr. Chris Blevins and Dr. Laurie Beard take us on a tour of the K-State Veterinary Health Center and explain the different types of cases they handle. We'll end today with the importance of maximizing good genes in beef market with tight margins. Closed captioning brought to you by Ag Promo Source. Together we grow. Learn more at agpromosource.com.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Regenerative Medicine. Your stem cells, your health, your life.
Hello, my name is Dr. Ignacio Ciampitti, and we are here in Wichita on our first 2017 Kansas State Corn School. Key topics that several speakers were highlighting on this event were related to weed control, very critical for successful corn production, economics, fertilization and corn efficient and use of nutrients, looking at soil sampling, looking about how to improve efficiency. Some other topics also were involved all around the idea of input savings and also the efficiency. We have speakers connecting insects applications and updating on insects issues in corn. Speakers also connecting us with disease, importance of disease and new disease on corn and how they are affecting productivity if we don't treat it right on time. New topics as speed planters and how those speed planters, how fast we can plant corn. And then my presentation was more focused also on efficiency. And I think that efficiency is one of the key topics for 2017. When I'm talking about efficiency, we're not talking about maximizing yields, but we are talking about maximizing yields by minimizing input cost. And that's a key topic for next coming years in our this challenging production environment. So key aspects to consider from the corn production standpoint: seeding rate, look at the right seeding rate for your right yield environment. Second aspect, look at the hybrid, okay? Hybrid is a key factor. Hybrids are, they are less expensive, but still high yielding or very good yielding for your area. It might be your best choice. So hybrid selection is another factor when you're looking about savings. Look about on-farm ideas, on-farm type of research. Looking about narrow rows in some situations, whenever we can probably find good planters and good possibility to use narrow rows to improve weed control and minimize, I mean, the use of inputs for controlling weeds and closing the canopy faster. And another last point that I focused my presentation was on the on-farm research, how we are helping farmers on really fine-tuning the production systems. I mean, seeding rate is a really great example of, if you are looking at your own farm, you might find very different possibilities of optimizing your yields based on productivity, based on different environments. So stay tuned, more information on these topics will come soon, very soon in the near future. Also, as an outcome of these programs, we'll have very soon coming our soybean and sorghum schools. So make sure to check on agronomy.ksu.edu, our website for the K-State Agronomy Department. In that website, you will find the e-update tab. Click on the e-update, and you will find all the information on how to register to our soybean and sorghum schools. Three soybean schools will offer across the state, and it will be in the week of January 24th. And we are going to Parsons. Then from there, we are going to Heston, and then the last school will be in Highland Community College. On sorghum, we will go four locations. It will be on the week, last week of January, first week of February, and we will go from Colby, then from there, Wichita, Concordia, and our last one will be in Iola. So make sure to check on those schools and make sure to register before the event, and we'll look forward to see you all there.
Soil is the life of a farm, and for 25 years, SureCrop Liquid Crop Nutrition has helped growers produce abundant quality crops while preserving and improving the soils they steward. SureCrop offers complete soil and plant analysis with cropping recommendations, delivery direct to your on-farm storage, and quality crop nutrition custom blended for your field. Choose SureCrop for the assurance of excellence for your soil. Call today or visit their website for more information.
Valley Vet Supply is devoted to providing information and professional quality products at reasonable prices.
Valley Vet Supply.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Wheat. Learn more at rediscoverwheat.org.
Hello, folks. Dr. Nels Lindberg here with Production Animal Consultation and Animal Medical Center out of Great Bend, Kansas. Today, we want to talk about people. And people is something we have to deal with every day, whether you employ them or they're part of your team or they're not part of your team and you don't employ them, you still deal with people on a daily basis, inside your operation or outside of your operation. And so today here we've got Luke Knight here. We're at Knight Feed Yard in Lyons, Kansas. And Luke here is the manager of this feed yard. And so as we think about people, Luke, tell me what is your, number one issue or challenge on a daily basis or that you deal with here?
Well, I think the hardest part for me has been getting people to buy into what we're trying to do. I think it's important for me as a manager to lead my people in the direction that we're trying to go and be clear to them what's expected of them. And so my biggest challenge has been to try to show people the direction we're wanting them to go.
Yeah, so really when we think about that, it's about expectations and clearly telling them their expectations, as well as sharing what the yard's purpose or vision or goal is, and that is our why, why we do what we do here. So at Knight Feed Yard, our why and most beef producers is we produce great, awesome, wholesome beef, right?
Yep.
And so as we think about expectations, what's one way that you do those things or relay those to them? How do they know?
So I think the easiest thing to do is just set them down, explain what direction we're trying to go as a yard and what their role is and how they can help us achieve that goal that we're after. Just being very clear with them. No gray area, just
sure.
Black and white, explaining how they can contribute and what we expect on a daily basis.
Yeah, so that's perfect. And so in our setting, in any setting, in the ag business, whatever it might be, we all have teams that we work with, again, whether we employ them or not employ them, but we need to think about sitting down with our people, sitting down with them on a regular basis, weekly, monthly, whatever it might be, daily even. But we need to help our people understand their why. Why do they do what they do every day? We need to share what is our purpose with our people so they can know what their purpose is and what the operation's purpose is so they can help carry out those goals. And in that process, that really is about our expectations. And so once you start lining out those sort of things, what their why is, what our purpose is, and our visions and expectations, I think if you do that regularly, routinely, tell them time and time again, awesome things can begin to happen. So give those things some thought. So Luke, keep after it. Thanks for your time, everybody, and give those words some thought, and you guys keep after it too. Thank you.
Hey, I'm Clark Victory. I grew up right here on this little ranch near Chelsea, Oklahoma. Roped and ranched all my life, and a few years ago I had an injury that created what they call a frozen shoulder in layman's terms. It got to the point that I couldn't reach, I couldn't sleep, I couldn't do anything. After speaking with the surgeon in Tulsa, he finally told me that he could make my shoulder better if he did surgery, but he absolutely couldn't fix it. I decided that maybe I better listen to my friend John, and I called Kansas Regenerative Medical Center. I talked to Patrick Farley and was just excited about the whole aspect of going up there and having the opportunity to focus on getting better. The next morning at 8:30, went into the clinic, did the stem cell replacement. By 12:30, my wife and I had lunch and was driving back to Chelsea. I feel better. We work around here. Some days we work pretty hard around here, and like any older guy does, I get pretty sore, pretty tired, but my right shoulder doesn't get sore. It's like a baby's arm.
Ag Promo Source is a unique group of marketing specialists with one mission: help your ag business grow. Each affiliate has their own area of expertise, and they work together to bring you advice, products, and services. To get started, visit agpromosource.com. Ag Promo Source, together we grow.
KFRM is one of the largest farm radio stations in the nation, dedicated to informing and entertaining rural listeners from northern Oklahoma to southwestern Nebraska. You can catch KFRM in many ways, of course, 550 on the AM dial, streaming at KFRM.com, or on your smartphone by going to the TuneIn Radio app, or on Ag AM in Kansas on Tuesdays and Facebook every day of the week. KFRM, tune us in. You'll be glad you did.
Valley Vet Supply is devoted to providing information and professional quality products at reasonable prices.
The Kansas Wheat Innovation Center in Manhattan is rediscovering ways to get improved varieties and new genetics in the hands of farmers faster. Grower-led and Checkoff-funded research initiatives are bringing about positive change. This grassroots leadership provides a strong voice in Topeka and Washington, D.C. Now is the time to partner with Kansas Wheat in moving wheat forward. Kansas Wheat Commission and Kansas Association of Wheat Growers. Farmers investing in their future and yours. Log on to rediscoverwheat.org.
This segment brought to you by SureCrop, liquid crop nutrition delivered right to your farm.
Hello and welcome to Horsin' Around. I'm Dr. Chris Blevins at Kansas State University Veterinary Health Center, and today joined by Dr. Laurie Beard. She is a clinical professor here at Kansas State and is the section head for equine. And today thought we'd just kind of go over, you know, if an owner had either an issue with their horse or they're just wanting to come to visit. First of all, I'd like to start with, what kind of people do we have in the equine section and what kind of cases do we kind of see here?
Yeah, so very good question. So we have a number of different veterinarians that work on horses, and we do everything. So Dr. Blevins, he is our field service veterinarian, so he's gonna be able to see your horse out in the field, or he often sees a number of cases in-house. So he does a lot of vaccines and dentistries and just primary care veterinary work. We also have veterinarians that specialize. So I'm an internist. I see problems that would be medically treated. For instance, pneumonias, diarrheas, neurologic cases, see a lot of foals in the spring. We have surgeons that do soft tissue surgery. They do orthopedic surgeries. They also do a lot of the lameness, laceration type of repairs. We actually have somebody too that does our work in reproduction or theriogenology. And so we have a lot of different areas. We also have other support veterinarians that do work on all animals, but we have board certified ophthalmologists, we have board certified cardiologists, we have board certified anesthesiologists as well. So we've kind of got everything your horse needs, from the very basic to the more complicated. I'd also like to state that you don't need a referral to come to Kansas State University. So your veterinarian can certainly refer your horse,
but if you have a situation in which you think, gosh, my horse has a serious problem, I want to bring it, you are more than welcome to schedule an appointment yourself to bring your horse here.
I think those are all good points and things to remember for owners, that they're always welcome. Any questions or concerns, to just get a hold of us, and we're here for them. And for your veterinarian, for sure, for that too. Where we are at is actually the large animal.
Where exactly the equine section is when you would drop off or unload your horse. We are on the back side of Mosier Hall. So you'll see the emergency sign up front off of Denison, but then you'll have to drive around to the back side, and that's where we unload the horses and get started. So just making sure people kind of understand that we're not necessarily right on the front of the building. You have to kind of drive around to the back side of the building, and there are a lot of signs to help you direct you into that to that location. So this is kind of the area that you can see behind us of where they would start and sign in for whatever they need or concerns, and then there's pages that go out and students that get involved.
Yes.
Kind of what would happen next after they get checked in, as far as what would go and who would be around?
Yeah, so you would come in here, you'd get checked in, and what's going to usually happen at that point is that there's going to be a fourth-year student that comes out, introduces themselves, they're going to get a history from you, we'll get your animal brought in. They may start with a physical exam, but very shortly you're going to be then introduced to the senior clinician. We also have some junior faculty, some residents, interns. They're all veterinarians, but they'll be part of this as well. Certainly, if you have an animal that's critically sick, and we do have those, we're going to be involved from the get-go. So it'll depend on those situations. But usually this is a place where the students are going to come, at least get that history, and where you're going to help get your horse off the trailer and into the building.
Yeah. So, and I think that's a good point. This is a quality area for any aspects of the equine medicine and surgery, and you're going to get the top-notch care. And we're also teaching students. So there's a lot of stuff that's going on. There's a lot of people, but definitely a lot of veterinarians that get involved with
cases. Yeah, one thing we're on never short supply is people.
Yes.
And so there will be a lot of people you'll be introduced to, fourth-year students, technicians, faculty, senior, junior faculty, and again the house officers as well. So these are veterinarians in training programs to specialize in whatever field they've chosen.
That's great. Well, I think next, after they get checked in, why don't we go and show them where their horse may be examined?
Sure.
Grain sorghum is one of the most important cereal crops worldwide, and Kansas leads the nation in its production. Over the years, sorghum has been either exported, used in animal feed domestically, or for other industrial uses. Recently, its use in the ethanol market has seen tremendous growth, with 30% of domestic sorghum typically going to ethanol production. Kansas Grain Sorghum is committed to sorghum research, market development, and education. Learn more at ksgrainsorghum.org.
We do business with Blueville because of the quality of their work. It is excellent quality, and because they make a commitment to their customers.
We enjoy the benefits of hiring a good company to help us maintain this home.
We will always do business with Blueville. We have for many, many years, and there's no reason for us to look for any other service.
Tallgrass Commodities offers producers bulk commodities at a reasonable price with reliable service throughout the whole Midwest. To find out more about Tallgrass Commodities, visit tallgrass.us or call 785-494-8484.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Corn. Learn more at kscorn.com.
Okay, so now we're in one of the exam rooms that we would use for horses after they get checked in. There's kind of a large area where they kind of unload. Maybe the student would do the exam. But this room gets used quite a bit. Could you explain a little bit about the room that we're in right now?
Yeah, so it's one of our general exams rooms. Sometimes we refer to it as the colic room, but we will see a lot of different horses, not necessarily just colic in this area. But the room, we have a set of stocks here that we're gonna usually try to get your horse in. Not always successful, but that's usually we do our exam in the stud stocks. And this is actually where we're gonna do our general workup. So we're gonna get basic physical exams, so temperature, heart rate, respiratory rate. We're gonna listen to the heart and the lungs. Do we need to pass a tube? Do we need to do a rectal exam? Do we need to pull out an ultrasound? So we'll do all those things. And in some situations, we have a pretty critical horse. We may have multiple veterinarians here doing things simultaneously. Students will be involved. They'll be involved in doing things like listening to the heart, getting that temperature, that sort of mm-hmm. thing. So this is that area we can do it. We also have a set of scales over here so we can actually get accurate weights on our large patients.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's something too is when they come here, usually the owner, depend on the case, but they sure can be back here and are communicated during the process. So it's not like you drop something and you have to wait in some little room to figure out what's going on. We try to keep people involved. And yeah, you know, you can look in here sometimes and there'll be like eight different veterinarians and eight students and all doing different things and communicating with each other. Depending on the case, even like anesthesiologists will come in here if it's going to have to go to surgery. They'll get stuff ready from here too.
Yeah, and that's the big difference between When we work on large animals or equine in particular, the owner is part of this. And so in small animal, maybe you've had that experience where they've taken your dog, taken it to a different room, and you're not around for the examination. That's not going to be the case in this situation. We're working right with the clients, right with the horses. And so the clients are involved. They're involved with asking questions. So all those sort of things.
Yeah, and the decision process, you know, they're, I think you guys do a great job of just communicating where they're at, even financially, you know, what are some options, here's what we have. And so I think that's a big part of it, that maybe some people kind of are hesitant of coming because they think everything is just going to be, you know, thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. But I think there's different options, and we work with the client and trying to figure out what's best for the patient for sure, but also for that of the client.
Yeah, and that's something that's really, when I talk to my students, one of my jobs is to know exactly what things cost, and it's the client's money. The clients get to decide how they want to care for their horse. So we usually come up with some different options, different plans, explaining those options and plans to the owner to understand what they're getting into.
I think all those things are great, and I think that I sure appreciate you kind of shedding light a little bit on that, Terry, for that of owners. If you guys have any questions or concerns, just give us a call here at Kansas State Veterinary Health Center, and either about your patient or even about the facility. We'd sure be welcome to any aspects and talking to you on that. Thank you, Dr. Beard, in talking today. And I'm Dr. Chris Blevins for Horsing Around, and we'll see you around.
Buying a car shouldn't be this hard. And at Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego, it isn't. It's actually awesome. Whether you want a new or used car or truck, Toby's team can make the deal. Even if you want to custom order a new car or truck, Toby's team can make the deal. See Toby's team at Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego. We're awesome.
The new Better Horses Network is worldwide, presented by Lucas Oil, featuring worldwide radio and TV with iconic hosts like Al Dunning, Sharon Camarillo, Ernie Rodina, Lindy Birch, and Craig Cameron. With American Cowboy, Horse and Rider, Brushy Creek, Cavenders, and Ride TV. Worldwide radio and TV, the all-new Better Horses Network.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Soybean Commission. Progress powered by Kansas farmers.
Changing beef markets call for even more genetic focus.
As we go forward, especially in times of tight margins and the risk that we have in the marketplace, anything that can be done genetically to narrow that down and to focus on some of the premiums that are possible that way, I think gives the cow-calf producer especially a great advantage. Perhaps as much as anyone in the industry to take advantage and to be rewarded for the effort that they can put into improving genetics that way.
The cattle feeder gives credit to cow-calf producers for the improvement in quality over the years.
Genetics is a huge factor, and we know that there's great variation even within breeds in terms of genetic potential of the cattle. And even this spring we had two loads of cattle that graded 40% prime. And so, you know, that speaks, those were both from producers that have put an emphasis on quality. And it's just interesting and encouraging to see what progress can be made as people focus on those things, and then to not lose track of the cutability and growth factors that are important as well, too.
The crew at this Marquette, Kansas feed yard works to manage the animals in a way that makes the most of their genetics.
That's one thing, a smaller operation of our size, we can focus more, I think, on individual sorting and attention to customers, and knowing a history with them too of what their cattle are capable of. And so we do actively sort cattle to try to maximize their potential and harvest them before they've been around too long.
But he's still working every day to optimize that potential.
The biggest adjustment we can make, I think, from a management standpoint is being aware of the potential of the cattle, and then using our sorting and then evaluating which particular grid might be best to use to market the cattle in to get the best premium we can for our customer that way.
That kind of teamwork works in every market. I'm Bob Cervera.
closed captioning brought to you by Ag Promo Source. Together we grow. Learn more at agpromosource.com.